We continue on section 20.2. The last topic of Fourier transform is Fourier transforms in three-dimensional space. So basically, 3D Fourier transform is just a straightforward generalization from the 1D Fourier transform. So we can write down the formula directly. So F. Now it depends on, instead of one number k, it becomes a three-dimensional number, three-dimensional vector, which has k, depends on your coordinate system, like kx, ky, kz, if you have a Cartesian coordinate for k, and that it equals to 1 over 2 pi to the 3/2 power. So for one dimension is 1/2 power. So three dimension, you basically have three of them. So you have 3/2 power, and you integrate the function f t, and then e to the ik dot all, and integrate over the volume, so integrate by d3o, and over all space, over all the whole volume. So basically, if you are using Cartesian coordinate, both x, y, z are from negative infinity to infinity, just like the 1D case. Okay, so that's the 3D Fourier transform, and likewise, the function itself is the inverse Fourier transform in 3D, or the Fourier representation, is using this notation, this convention, is still have the same coefficient in front, 1 over 2 pi to the 3/2 power. Now integrate over the Fourier transform. F, oh, I should say this is not T. Now you change that to a function of three-dimensional space FR, and likewise, this is FR is integrate over the Fourier transform, multiply e to the negative I k dot R. Integrate of the three-dimensional space in wave number k. So these twos are complementary, except this exponential function have a different sign. They are basically of the same form, this 3D integration. So now we can look at some examples. Example 20.2.5. So the first one is the Fourier transform of FR is e to the minus r, it's alpha r. So it only depends on the spherical radial coordinate. Okay. And I calculated the Fourier transform in the textbook using this square bracket superscript T to represent them. So basically, just calculate this Fourier transform e to the minus of and Fourier transform. It's basically putting this into the formula. So 1 over 2 pi. Integrate over this. When you put this in, there are different ways to do the integration. So the most difficult part is this e to the I k dot r. And in your textbook, it uses an expansion in chapter 16, which we haven't covered. It's basically a spherical harmonic expansion of this exponential factor, and that involves a Spherical-Bessel function also, we talk about spherical-Bessel function, but this formula itself we haven't talked about. So we actually can do the integral just using another way to do this. So this 3D integral, we can change that to a integral in spherical coordinate. So because now this function is e to the minus of depends only on radial coordinate. We integrate over spherical coordinates, so the radial part in r squared dl from 0 to infinity. And then there's a theta part, so you have a sine theta d theta. Theta is from 0 to pi. And then you have d phi. Zero to two pi. Now this exponential I k dot r, we can choose k. If we consider k, this is a function of k. If we use k vector, this basically is the z vector in the spherical coordinate system. So k dot r becomes just k r cosine theta, so this will be I, K, R, cosine theta. Okay, so we can do that, this integration. All right, and now the phi term is easy because it's nothing depends on phi in this, in the integram, so you integrate 2 pi out, so cancel part of the 2 pi, you only have 1 over square of 2 pi. And now the radial integration is 0 to infinity. Exponential function minus alpha r, then r dr. Okay. And then this integration, the theta integration, you can change that to sine theta d theta, you can change the d cosine theta and flip the limit and change the limit to minus 1 to 1. And then this will be e to the I r cosine theta. Cosine theta. So basically this becomes simple exponential function integration. This first, and then there'll be r dependence from here. So this integration will be, you have a 1 of I k out, and then e to the I k r cosine theta. Evaluate minus 1 to 1. Okay. And so that would be so you have IK doesn't depend on it at all. So you have multiply IK down square of 2 pi. And all cancel. So you have 0 to infinity. Okay. And then you have exponential minus r over r, and can multiply this, combine this with the both upper limit and lower limit. So that will have two terms. So you have one term is e to the minus r over minus I k times r. The lower limit give you e to the minus alpha plus ik. Okay, now this one is also an exponential function, so you can do that in a straightforward manner. And ik. Okay, so After you do the exponential function, you evaluate from lower limit to upper limit. The upper limit is always zero because of this minus alpha r factor. So only the lower limit will give you the result. And the lower limit is zero, so that all the exponential function give you one. Okay, so then this, so the first one will be one over of minus ik, because it's in the lower limit, and the other is minus one over alpha plus ik. Okay, so and now I can group the two and the common denominator will have alpha squared plus k squared, and then the numerator have 2ik, and 2ik cancel with the ik with ik. So basically you have 2 out, the ik cancel, so you have a square of 2 pi square of 2 pi, and then 1 over alpha squared plus k squared. Okay, so that should be the answer. Now, that would be let's see. 4, 2, 2.2. Yeah, that is the one. So this is equivalent to equation 20.41. This is 20.41. Okay, so that's the first example. All right. So this is number one. So number two is a direct consequence of this one. It's basically now instead of e to the I, e to the minus alpha r of r becomes just one of r, okay, to the Fourier transform. This case basically setting alpha is zero in alpha as zero in here, so it's basically just one over 2 over pi, so one over k squared. But that is the answer. So this is for 20.42. All right, so that kind of easy. Number three is one of r square t. Now what basically is saying that the Fourier transform, inverse Fourier transform, basically is of the same form of the integration. So we can from here, one of r, the Fourier transform 1 over r give you 1 over k squared. Okay, so if you put so the 1 over k squared, the inverse Fourier transform will give you square of pi over 2 times 1 over r. So 1 over r square transform will give you pi over 2 1 over k. Okay. That is the answer is 20.43. Okay, so the number four is the Fourier transform of the Fourier transform of e to the, just exponential from e to the minus c times O Fourier transform. And that can be written as taking the minus d dz over the minus z O over O, because that will cancel the O. You take the derivative of my d dz and take the negative sign, will give you this one. So basically you're saying that you can take the Fourier transform of this one, which we already done that in here, except that instead of alpha, you call it z. Okay, and take the derivative of that one. So that one is like in your textbook, which is quite straightforward. You just take the derivative of this one over alpha, actually. So I'll change the z squared. So whatever you have there, that you have. So alpha squared. This is with square, and then you have the 2 alpha out, or in this case 2z. Okay, so this would be 2 alpha 2z over z square plus k square square. Okay, so that is 20.44. Okay. And number five is something that involves again in expansion in spherical harmonics in chapter 16. So this is we haven't talked about it, so we'll skip that one. So. And number six is again a Gaussian. Now it's a three-dimensional transform. So e to the minus alpha square transform. Okay, so then again your textbook do an integration involve a spherical Bessel function. But there's another way to do that, because this is a Fourier transform in 3D. So you can actually write it like, we go back to the Fourier transform is like that. So you can write it like, instead one of a square root of 2 pi to the 3 half power, you separate into 3 square root of 2 pi, and then you integrate in Cartesian coordinates. So you have dx from minus infinity to infinity, and separate the exponential function in as e to the minus alpha x squared, because r squared is x squared plus y squared plus c squared. And then you have exponential function I, instead of k dot x, k dot r here, you have kx times x. Kx times x. Okay. And you do this integration, you multiply by exactly the same for y. Minus alpha y square e to the I k y do the same thing of z, minus alpha z square plus I k z z. Okay, so each one is, each of these square bracket is just a 1D Gaussian Gaussian Fourier transform, which we have already done that in a previous example. This is the example this is 20.2.2. Okay, so the Fourier transform is 1 for square root of 2 alpha, which, so each one has a 2, 1 over square root of 2 alpha, so you have 2, 1 over 2 alpha to the 3 half power. An exponential function minus 1 over 4 alpha. And then your omega square in that example, which is now is kx squared times ky squared times kc squared. So you add up, it will be just k squared. Okay, so that would be minus, so k minus k squared over 4 over 1 over 2. Although your text rate is a, but doesn't matter. So, so this would be the answer. Okay, so this is another way to get the same Fourier transform. All right, so we cover all the examples except one in this section. So, and next time we'll move to the next section.